In Alex.
Well, good morning, all. Today we're at the Animal Kingdom. Hi, Reagan.
Hi, I didn't know I'm on camera.
Yeah, you are. You're pretty. When you're with me, you're pretty much always on camera.
We just saw Divine.
Yeah.
She's
you know the person dresses up in like a
the
suit and all. Yeah, like she's supposed to look like a vine moving. You know, so it's like pretty self-explanatory, I guess. But. So we're going to our first fast pass. It was at the Navi River.
Yeah.
All right. So we're going over there right now, and.
And then we have dinosaurs.
Yep.
At 10:10.
Yeah, we have a floating whatever.
Yeah.
Because
we couldn't.
Me, so
we
can't do Primeval World.
Because we can't do Primeval World. I don't know why.
Change our fast pass.
But. I'll stay down here. Masa no kana.
Kevin. Kevin, who is apparently a girl from the movie. Kevin wanted to come.
Everything is
fine. I'm sure Dad's really looking forward to this.
Attention, expedition.
Mom and I are riding
members.
Together.
Once on board, secure all gear in the cargo.
I made it.
Obviously you made it. We're talking about Dad. And our second fast pass for today is, of course, Dinosaur. Is it weird that I like the smell in here?
I think it smells beer. It's not warm.
Thank you.
just know those last two or three clips, that wasn't the dinosaur ride, obviously.
Because I
took a video at the beginning of the dinosaur ride, and I said, okay, we're going on a dinosaur ride, and then I didn't have any actual, like, footage of the dinosaur ride. It just goes right into the Lion King. So that was the Lion King, and now we're at the bird show.
I told you not to have your phone out on dinosaur, because it jerks you around so much.
It was more of a recommendation. You did. She doesn't have the authority to tell me what to do with my phone, but.
Welcome back. Look, hey, thanks for rolling this explorer compass. We're here. We're really here. Wait, where is here?
Oh, you're in Anandapur, India.
Wow, we're in Ananda Panda. We're in India.
That's right, Anandapur. So, who are you?
My name is Russell, and I am a wilderness explorer in Tribe 54, Sweat Lodge 12.
Shabash, Russell. Oh, and who's your furry friend?
He's my dog. We found him in South America, and he's trained. Speak, boy. Speak, boy.
Hi there.
Oh, did he just say...
Hi there. My name is Doc.
Oh, my. I've never met a talking dog before.
Oh, yes, I can talk. I have just met you, and I love you.
Oh, I love you too, Doug. I'm Annika, a senior wilderness explorer from the local Chidiya tribe, Mor Lodge. Mor means peacock in the Hindi language.
Wait a minute. It's you. We found you.
Found me? Was I lost?
If you were lost, I am a great tracker. I can find you. Oh, yes, I can, because squirrel!
We know you. We read about you in our Wilderness Explorers newsletter.
Oh, yeah! The news there about birds from around the world, right?
Yeah, now we're ready to have a new bird adventure.
Well, you're in the right place! Say, that's a nifty camera, Russell.
I use it to take pictures for my adventure book.
I used to have one just like it. You know, they don't make those anymore.
Really? It's my Wilderness Explorer camera. Hey, are they wilderness explorers too?
Oh, I bet they are explorers and perfect. Now, hold it.
All right, you guys are doing an awesome job too. Just keep still and keep an eye for Miles. He'll be coming from the back this time. Let's see if he'll make a flight. Boys, what do you think, pal? Get some more treats. Everybody's ready? Here we go. Welcome back.
Shabash. This guy is a ground hornbill, also from Africa.
And ground hornbills are really neat. You know, they get their name because they spend a lot of time on the ground. But the cool thing is they use the huge beak they have with the force of a sledgehammer.
Hey, let me get my camera.
Your camera? Oh no, that's his camera.
What?
That orange.
That was his camera?
Yeah.
No,
he is an angry birdie.
No, he's not angry, Doug.
Oh, I'm so sorry about your camera, Russell. Maybe we can fix it.
That's all right. My Wilderness Explorer camera. Safe and sound?
Are you alright, small mailman?
Well, at least I don't have to worry about breaking it anymore.
I'll find you a new camera. My gift to you.
End of the day, safari. And we're gonna go get some lunch and chill out at the room probably for a little bit. I know Mom and Reagan are probably already took it out for the day. Understandably so, because it's so hot out here.
So we get a slightly better view at this massage giraffes again coming up right around the corner.
Wow.
Giraffes, of course, are the tallest animals in the world. They can reach heights of up to 18 to 20 feet tall, and their tongues can also reach up to a foot and a half in length. Them reach those really, really high up tree branches. Giraffes also have four stomachs, so they spend most of the day eating to fill those stomachs, but they only spend 30 minutes out of the entire day sleeping. One group of giraffes is known as a tower.
Oh, they're
mama.
Oh, not my giraffe.
They're coming to say hi.
Oh, my goodness.
Giraffe crossing.
Giraffe crossing.
Crossing the road.
There's another baby.
To get to the other side.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's part of the natural habitat.
So you know
right
the
there.
Difference between what?
The
truck.
That truck.
Yeah, they know the difference.
Wow,
look what we
did, Baba. Oh, look at you.
Oh my goodness. Look how big he is. Awesome.
It just went right by the side of the truck here. Okay. Poor
giraffe. The elephants are a matriarchal society, which means, of course, that the females are in charge. In adulthood, male elephants will be kicked out of the herd and will live solitary lives from then on out. And female elephants will be pregnant with their little ones for up to 22 months. A little one is a relative term when you give a birth to a 300-pound calf.
Just as long as they have the donkeys on the opposite side of the park. What a cool joke.